my definition, and if this is one thing you're going to take out of this whole class, it's this last part here. You're going to forget everything else, but except Django. Talk about Django. When we look at black power, everybody has this conception that black power is the violence, is the black supremacy, that black people are better than white people. No. It's this concept of, Kwame Ture, Stokely Carmichael, one of the two biggest people that preach this idea, and it's one of the biggest things that happened with black thought during this time, that black is beautiful. Okay? And the whole thing, too, when we talk about the social construction of race, and we kind of talked about it last week in, I should be here all the time, in October, but it's not this black identity, that black is a negative thing. We talk about black person, talk about somebody that's wrong, cheating, stealing. The whole idea with this black power movement is to have black pride, self-empowerment, self-respect, and uplifting yourselves. And that's the same kind of thing we talk about with the Pan-African movement. It's this common movement to break out of the shackles, if you want to call them, the shackles of mental slavery. That you can say, you know what, I am someone. I wake up in the morning, I look in the mirror, and like, you know what, I love myself. The big problem, especially when you talk about the paper bag test, if you're darker than the paper bag, you're bad. But it's like, no, I might be as dark as asphalt, okay, or as a chalkboard. When you look in the mirror, you know, I love myself. You know? Big lips, big nose, hair not straight, dreadlocks, nappy hair, whatever you want to call it. You wake up in the morning, like, I love myself. I love what God made me. And that's the biggest thing when we talk about this whole idea of black power. You need to break this whole concept that black power is all about violence, picking up a gun, shooting somebody. No, self-respect. If you don't love yourself, how can you function in society? But the whole first part is to understand is that the powers that be are the ones that are oppressing you. Not just oppressing you for economics, not just saying you can't get a job, putting you in jail, but you're oppressing your mind. It's telling you that you are not good enough to function and wake up in the morning. You are not as good as a person sitting next to you. It's the same kind of thing if you look at feminist wave movements, that a woman is not as good as a man. But who said that? Who told a woman that she's not as good as a man? A man said that. You gotta break these concepts and break these ideas. And that's the biggest thing with the black power movement. And for the record, a lot of these movements, like gay power movement and feminist movement, came out of black power movement. For the record. But it's this whole idea of self